Assalamu alaikum students. Students, today we are going to perform another practical. The title of practical is determination of coefficient of discharge using various types of wear. So here are some types of wear. You can see this is the triangular wear having 90 degree angle. This wear has 30 degree angle, and this wear is trapezoidal wear, which is a combination of rectangle wear and triangular wear. So another wear we are already installed in our apparatus is rectangular wear, which is have width B. First we have to analyze our table. The first column of our table is Q actual, which we obtain from hydraulic bend directly, and it will give us in liter per second. So we just convert it cubic meter per second. And the next column is our height. So H capital height is that strip of water which is raised above the base of the wear. And the other column is Q theoretical, which we calculate from height and this formula, and H is the height and base, B is the base of the rectangular wear. So we can measure and see that it is almost 3.1 centimeter base. So now we find first our height h1. So you can measure this in this type of manner. We have a leveler. Our bubble of leveler must be in center, and you can down this gauge. So this is our reading h1. So you can see that it is 90 millimeter. That is 90 millimeter. So we note down it as 90 millimeter. So students, we have to take reading from this point, not this point, from this point in all over our practical. So students, we set up our practical apparatus, and you can see the discharge is stable, flow rate is stable. Now we are ready to take our first reading. So first we take discharge, that is Q actual, from liter per second. It is almost 0.25 liter per second. 0.25 liter per second. Now we are going to measure our H2. We are required. So we are required H capital, and we are here H1 is known, but H2 is unknown. So we first measure H2 from this gauge. So the tip of this scale just touch the water, you can see, and we are going to measure our H2. That is almost 65 millimeter. That is 90 minus 65 is equal to 25 millimeter. So 25 millimeter means 0.025 meter. So we already taken our first reading. Now we are going to change our flow rate. I am increasing the flow rate. That is almost 0.32. Wait some time until discharge is constant. You can see that this is upstream side and this is the downstream side, and it is a rectangular wear discharge. So we increase our discharge up to 0.47 almost, and that discharge is almost stable. So we are going to take our next reading. First we have to adjust our gauge. The tip of gauge is almost just touching the water level. So we can see from here the reading is 50 millimeter. So 90 minus 50, that is 40 millimeter. So you can see 0.04 meter, and discharge is 0.6 4772. So students, we increase our discharge up to 0.60 liter per second, and discharge is now stable. So we note down 0.603 liter per second our actual discharge, and we have to measure our height H2. So you can see it's about 44 millimeter. H2 is 44 millimeter, H1 is 90, so our H is 90 minus 44, that is 46 millimeter. So you can write 0.046 meter. So students, we convert Q actual from liter per second to cubic meter per second, and these are the values. Then we put in the formula of and calculate Q theoretical, just putting using the value of B and H, that is this, and the ratio of actual discharge and theoretical discharge are the reading of this, and the average coefficient of discharge is 0.668, and the range of coefficient of discharge is 0.6 to 0.9.